You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of The Diary of a Young Girl, a famous work by Anne Frank. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Anne Frank was a Jewish girl who has become a symbol of the persecution and extermination of Jews under the Nazi regime. Mounting anti-Semitism and the enactment of increasingly stringent anti-Jewish laws in the 1930s forced her family to emigrate from Germany to the Netherlands and eventually to go into hiding. Anne and seven other Jews spent 2 years hidden in the annexe of the building where her father worked in central Amsterdam. Her ambition was to become a writer or a journalist, and during her time in hiding she wrote not only her famous diary, but also short stories, essays, and personal recollections, which were published in 1949 under the title Tales from the Secret Annexe. The family was arrested in August 1944, probably after being denounced by an informer, and deported. Anne was sent to the Bergen-Belsen concentration camp, where she contracted typhus and died in early 1945. The work. In 1947, Otto Frank decided to publish his daughter's diary under the title Het Achterhuis, The Secret Annexe. Unlike the vast majority of published accounts of the Second World War, the text was intended to be private, in her diary, and describes her daily life in hiding, with all the restrictions that this involved, and reflects on her personality, her relationships with other people and the war in general. The Diary of a Young Girl is one of the most widely read books in the world. It has sold over 25 million copies to date and been translated into over 50 languages. Summary. Before going into hiding. The diary begins on June 12, 1942, the day of Anne's 13th birthday. The diary was given to her as a birthday present. At this point, Anne is leading a relatively uneventful life in Amsterdam. She spends time with her school friends, gets told off for talking too much in class, and has several admirers who do not interest her. Along with these typical teenage worries, Anne also writes about the tense situation in Europe at that time. Specifically, she mentions the anti-Jewish laws introduced by Hitler, German leader, 1889-1945, which are now being enforced in the occupied Netherlands. Jews are forced to wear a yellow star on their clothing and are banned from using public transport, going to entertainment venues and visiting the houses of Christians, among other restrictions. Going into hiding. In early July 1942, Anne's father Otto tells her that they will soon be going into hiding. Their departure is originally scheduled for July 16, but is brought forward by 1 week due to an alarming turn of events. Margot, Anne's older sister, is called up to work in a camp in Germany. Anne writes, "I was stunned. A call-up, everyone knows what that means. Visions of concentration camps and lonely cells raced through my head, Wednesday, July 8, 1942. The next day, the Frank family moves to the annexe, which comprises the unused rooms of the building where Otto works, not knowing that they will remain there for over 2 years. Anne's father's employees, Meep, BEP, Mr. Kleiman and Mr. Kugler, are in on the secret, and will be in charge of delivering provisions to those in hiding. Anne knows that her carefree childhood is well and truly over, but she still struggles to think of the annexe as her new home. The Van Don family, which consists of Otto's business partner and friend, his wife and their son, joins them on July 13. The Franks learn that rumors are circulating about their sudden disappearance. At first, Anne is thrilled by the arrival of their new companions, but the novelty soon wears off and tensions flare up. "I think it's odd that grown-ups quarrel so easily and so often and about such petty matters," Monday is September 28, 1942. Anne often finds herself at the center of these arguments, as the Van Dons accuse her of being too talkative and conceited. She also clashes with her mother and sister, with whom she feels that she has little in common. An eighth person. In November, the dentist Albert Dussel joins them in the annexe and moves into Anne's room. She regularly watches Jews being rounded up from the annexe window, and feels guilty that she can sleep in a bed every night while so many people are being arrested and deported. "I can't help thinking about those who are gone. I catch myself laughing and remember that it's a disgrace to be so cheerful," Friday, November 20, 1942. The Jews' fate and the war effort are constantly on the mind.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.